Hello and welcome back, audience, to episode 3 of my Southampton career mode. So, after seeing all the feedback and comments and likes on episode 2, it seems to be getting a bit better. You know, it seems to have increased a bit more. In episode 2, I actually asked people if they could comment, asking how I could get more of the FIFA community and the people who watch FIFA to come over and check out my videos. Lots of people tweeted me, lots of people liked the video, which helps me out a lot. It means people are recognising me. If you haven't already watched episode 2 or even episode 1, there will be links in the description below, and I would advise to go and watch episode 1 and then episode 2 and then come back and watch this one. Not much has happened in the first couple of episodes, but we've played 2 matches. We lost the first one 1-0. We won the second one 1-0 thanks to Victor Wanyama, who scored a cracking header. And we've also inquired over a few players, we've put a few bids in, but if you want to go and check all that out, the links will be in the description below for the previous 2 episodes. So, without any further ado, in 4 days we have our last final pre-season game. And if you remember at the end of episode 2, we had inquired about quite a few players. As you can see in the bottom left there, the Global Transfer Network, there is some of the players that we've inquired about. If we click into it, it might show us. We've inquired at the moment about 4 players, or possibly even more. So we've asked the scouts to have a look at Siglio, Sterling, Joel Matip, Morata, and for Keatuma, Pogba and Shaqiri, we have already had a scout report and we've put bids in. Now we know Shaqiri was looking at like 15.8 million, which is far too much. So we're going to remove him from the report because he's costing us far too much. And the Pogba bid we put in was actually rejected. So we simply put another bid in and we're still awaiting confirmation on whether it's been accepted or declined. And that's the same for Zuma. So hopefully in this episode we will know if Zuma or Pogba will be coming to Southampton, which will be lovely. So, if we head back now, all we can really do is advance in time. Now, this is the last pre-season game. So after this episode 3, every other episode now, 4, 5, 6, all the way to the end of the season or until FIFA 15 is released, it's going to be 2 matches per episode, apart from when we get to the January transfer window. Because when we're in the transfer window, I kind of want to take it slowly, release one episode, and then everyone can comment down below or tweet me of players that they would like me to buy. Now, after episode 2, only a few people had actually responded with players to buy. Some of them I've heard of, some of them I haven't. Now, there's a fella from Roma that people seem to be buzzing about, and I think his name is pronounced Adam Lajanek, maybe? I'm not too sure if that's how you pronounce his name, but people were talking about him. There was also, a player called Abel Hernandez, which I have heard of before because I actually play an online football manager type thing with people from the company I actually work for, and I've actually got him in my football team on that online manager mode. Basically, the manager mode works by, if they play well in real life, their rating goes up, and then we play this online manager thing, and his rating has been going up recently, so I'm thinking he's playing quite well. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to wait for everyone else to come back with updates on all Sterling and Morata, Siglio, and then I'm going to take it from there. Because if there's players in that group that we can buy, they are the ones I want to go for. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to jump over to the squad. I'm going to take a quick look at the squad, mix it up a little bit because players are going to be low on energy. Now I know we've got 4 days to rest them, but I just want to bring in new players that probably haven't played yet. Just so we can test them out before the proper Premier League kicks off, and that is when we race for the title. So, Wanyama had a brilliant game, and I think he definitely deserves a rest. He played the first game, and he was absolutely monster. Played the second game, scored a goal, and defended brilliant. So, we are going to give him a rest. And we are going to put in his place. We're actually going to try out Davis. There we go. And I'm also going to put Osvaldo in, because he played in the first match, but only maybe 20 minutes at the end. So, we're going to put him in. He can start. We're also going to put Ramirez in, because he hasn't had much of a start. We're going to put him in there. And I'm also going to look at the reserves and see if there's anyone else. Now, Nathaniel Clyne, I would like him to play, because I quite like him in real life. I've seen him play, and he's fairly quick. So I'm going to give him a starting chance. And I'm also going to look for someone to replace Rodriguez at right mid. Who do we put in for him? let's try this Isgrove. Let's give him a try. So we'll put him in there, but we will put Rodriguez on the bench. And we'll put him in for Mayuka, just in case we have to bring the... In case we start losing or we're getting our arses kicked, we'll bring on the big guns and hopefully pull it back. So that's going to be the starting 11. I know everyone's energy is still quite low, but hopefully when I simulate some days, the energy will go up because they're not playing, they're just resting. So we will advance now. Possibly even Pogba's and Zuma's emails are coming. There we go. So Juventus again have rejected the offer for Paul Pogba, and St Etienne have said the sum is still too low. So... go back on Zoomers. Yeah, we'll offer a new, or we'll submit a new offer even. See, we're offering quite a bit now. Considering we're Southampton, we haven't got loads of money to be chucking around. Right, let's try 3.2 million and a player. Let's try this Billy Sharp. Now he is worth 1.6 and we're offering 3.2. So that's right in the region of what they want for him, so we'll submit that and hopefully that'll be accepted. Now as for Pogba, I really don't want Pogba to slip. I really do like Pogba and he's a hell of a player on FIFA. So what we will do is, so we'll offer now 6.2 and see, we haven't got many players with a high value. We will off Billy Sharp as well, so that's 6.2 and a player. Let's see what they think of that. Right, let's advance another 2 days. As you can see there on the right, Bale's looking at moving to Bayern. Now we've had a transfer offer in now. Is this a loan? It is a loan for a 18-year-old centre-back. Now, I did put in the first episode all the youngsters up for loan simply because they can go out on loan. They can all see how they play, they might have good potential, they might not play very well, they might be unhappy, and then we'll take it from there. Now, Jay Rodriguez has sent an email saying that basically he wants to play in the next match, and he doesn't want to be on the subs bench. Now, Jay Rodriguez is someone we want to keep hold of. We really don't want to look at losing him or him asking to hand in his transfer request. So what we'll do is, we'll go on to the team now. Everyone's full of energy now, which is all good, and we will take... take Reed off. We might bring him on into... oh no, he plays left, Rodriguez. What other positions can Rodriguez play? Left mid or striker. Now Lallana's playing left mid. Can left... Lallana play in other positions? Lallana can't even play right mid. So what we'll do is we'll swap the right mid for the left mid. And then we'll take the left mid off and we'll put Rodriguez in. And what we'll do is maybe after half time we'll bring Isgrove on just to see how he plays. And we'll go from there. Now Jay Rodriguez should be happy. Now he's getting in the starting 11. Right, let's jump straight into this and hopefully we can get a win out of this one. And then we'll have won 2 out of 3 of our starting games. Or our pre-season games, sorry. Right, as always guys, we're just going to start off nice and slow. We're just going to simply pass it round. If we get a break, we get a break. If we see a bit of a run being made or we see a gap, we'll attempt to put it through, but we'll go straight on defensive. We'll just keep the ball, keep possession, hopefully try and get a goal in the first half. If not, we'll come out second half and go a bit more attacking. Together up in
the
commentary position.
The Saints, can they go and march again, Southampton? Alan, what do you think?
Mixed fortunes for this team. First two matches, a win and a loss. So the second win would set them up nicely for the big kickoff.
They're eyeballing each other, those two.
That was a bad pass.
Lee Yun Fun. Shaw. Jay Rodriguez. Rodriguez.
Now we're struggling. Just get rid of her.
Daniele De Sena. Raja Nainggolan. As for Southampton, well, this is a game they can win. They'll have to be playing at their very best if they are to win it. Avalar. Return pass. Looking for Nainggolan.
What's a cross in, but
attack has fizzled out.
It's over the line. Kick.
Sal. looking good, this move.
Lovely tackle.
Ball now under control and a chance to move themselves forward. Get up the pitch to Davis.
Lovely touch there. Can he break through? Davis is running. Can he get one in? He puts one in. No one's there. Osvaldo did not even bother to jump.
The opposition will get a throw here because they've tried to play it into the
This
wide
is the
areas.
Problem, you see. When we get an opportunity like this, we need to be putting it away.
Raja Nainggolan. Chance for him. And he shoots. Oh, the shot was blocked.
Osvaldo had two chances there.
That was Reed.
This Reed is not playing well. Oh, fake shot past him, puts it in. Oh, unfortunately Reed couldn't get to it. Ramirez. Oh, and Ramirez has been brought down on the edge of the box. Is it a penalty? Or is it a free kick? I think it's going to be a free kick, isn't it? Right on the edge. Now, I don't really know who's good at free kicks or not. Osvaldo's not too bad. Davis isn't too bad. We'll go with Davis. Oh no, I've pressed the wrong button. Oh no. Oh, it's just shocking. I pressed A to change free kick taker and he passed it. And
that injury is.
Oh no.
We were worried about it at the time, Alan, weren't we? And
this is not what we want.
Got the better of him, I'm afraid.
Yeah, it was quite a little collision he took there, and straight away he looked in a little bit of pain.
Gaston Ramirez injured in a pre-season game. This is not what we want. Oh, come on. He's got a bruised elbow. Thought it was going to be something really bad, like a broken collarbone or something, but he's bruised his elbow. And I bet you any money, guys, we get an email saying he's out for like a week or 2 weeks with a bruised elbow. Never mind, he's going to have to come off, but we will put on, let's put on Snyderlin. He played well in the first game.
Well, the manager's going to take him off, and the player, I think, agrees with it. He's
go on, Ramirez, go off with your poor bruised elbow.
There's a risk of aggravating an injury.
Yeah, it might have been something that they were aware of that had been niggling him, so no point in taking chances.
Go on, Reed, run. Lovely.
Reed. Lorenzo Arialdo. And back it goes.
Oh no, he skipped past him.
Campos. Positional play.
Oh, that was unfortunate.
Really Victor Ibarbo.
See, he's another player people have mentioned. Ibarbo. Has Rodriguez got the legs? Oh, he hasn't. Plays back to keeper. Keeper deals with it.
Reed.
Here's Reed. Lovely ball over to Davis.
Here's Davis.
Lallana. Can Davis get past? Nope. He's staying on him though. Puts him under pressure and he has to put it out. It's our ball.
Might do a crossover the two players here to receive the throw. Make a chance maybe. Cross is blocked.
Can Klein get past him? Has he got the legs? He has. Can he put it in? He has. Oh, straight into the keeper's hands.
But it was an easy catch to deal with.
This is where we need Osvaldo in front of the keeper, jumping high.
Jay Rodriguez.
Oh, it's through to Reed. Oh, what's happened here is Rodriguez been brought down. He has. Do we go from a shot? Oh, let's have a shot. Oh.
Did pretty well to get that close from there.
Can't believe he actually tried a shot, but he made the keeper work.
Ekdal. Pisano. Campos.
Lovely tackle by Reed. Lovely.
Indication, four added minutes.
Klein's making the run. Plays a fake shot. Plays it back again. Takes a touch. Oh, he tries to get the cross in. Takes a deflection. Out for a corner. Can Reed whip a good one in? Oh.
Well, that is a waste of a corner.
Osvaldo.
Oh, volley. It wasn't a
goalkeeper. Lallana dicks it past. Oh. Done well to deal with that cross. So it's half time and we're still. So we're going in half time, 0-0.
I think the manager's going to say at half time, well, keep doing the same and you will get a goal because they've opened up the opposition time and time again.
I think that's dead right, Martin. They will take them this time.
So we've reached half time and the game is scoreless. Let's take a look at the highlights from that first half and then we'll be straight back to your commentary team for the rest of the game.
Right, guys, the more I play with Southampton, the more I realise I think we need a striker. I mean, Osvaldo's alright. He's tall, he's probably quite good ahead, and he's an 80 overall. And then we've got Lambert, who's a 76. Now, with two players like this, I think by the end of the season, they're going to have dropped maybe two or three ratings because of their age. And I think we really need to bring a young striker in that can maybe... People mentioned, I think his name's Zachariah Bacali. I don't want to be bringing in a player that's like 2 million and then in 5 years he's going to be worth like 100 million to Barcelona. I don't want to be doing that. I want to play realistically. Southampton would not bring in Bacali. And I know lots of players, or lots of teams and clubs, sorry, are after him at the moment. But Southampton are not one of them. So what I'm actually going to do is, for a change, since I haven't done this and it is only a pre-season game, I'm actually going to change the formation. I'm going to play so there's two up front. And we're still going to keep a CDM. So we're going to play this formation, which is a 4-1-3-2. So we've got four defenders, one CDM, three midfielders, two strikers. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to drop Rodriguez back for Reed. And I'm actually going to take Reed off. And I'm going to play Lambert and Osvaldo up front with each other. And maybe they've got a partnership where they can work together, play the through balls, make the runs. And hopefully this might just make something because... Although we're only pre-season games, we're not making enough runs and we're not making enough goal opportunities. We need to be making more.
Match which is level.
So we're just going to see how this goes.
Rodriguez.
Here's Klein on the run, down the wing. Look at this pace. See, just nobody's in the box.
Here's the cross.
Puts it in.
Looking for Osvaldo.
Osvaldo should be there. Come on.
Very promising attack.
Oh,
they've got the free kick, the referee's given it and decided to stop the attack.
Thought that was actually for me, but never mind. It's Mark up, he's probably going to play it over there to the wing, but never mind. Oh no, nope, he doesn't.
Sal. Pisano.
Lovely tackle there by Shaw.
Campos.
Come on, Fonte.
Options available on the bench for the away side today. Astori. And it's back to him again. Raja Nainggolan. Here's a chance.
Oh, that was unfortunate. If Osvaldo could have got his back heel through there, we could have been through. Just play it calm.
Joseph.
Nothing stupid. Well, keep compact.
To his mate, he's got it back again. Lambert. Challenged quickly by the opposition.
Lambert's kept it in, that's good. Osvaldo's in the middle. Can he get to it?
And it's a heading chance now. He's hunted down the defender.
Played over to Klein. Can Klein take a touch past? He does, he gets past. Osvaldo in the middle. Oh, and there he is. Pablo Osvaldo. Golazo! It's just what we need. 65 minutes. Osvaldo's in the right place at the right time. Ball comes in. Lovely from Klein. Osvaldo's in the right place. Heads it down. Boom. Straight over the keeper. 1-0. Now, can we get two? Let's push for two.
And the score is 1-0. They'll need to try and get the ball back now. Pisano. Raja Nainggolan. Could be dangerous.
Lovely interception by Rodriguez. Oh, he's done him.
Adam Lallana. Sal.
There we go, we're breaking. Oh, that was unfortunate.
Victor Ibarbo.
Gotta watch him, Ibarbo. Pacey.
Positioning, and the interception is made. Well, here we've got the possession stats so far for you coming up on the screen.
Well, nothing to split the two sides. So when you're looking for somebody to pick out a hole, create the pass, create the goal.
Lambert's battling. Ball goes over there, throwing.
They decided to make it.
Oh no, it's a half throwing.
And being behind, you can understand that.
Come on, Klein, move.
Defender raises his leg to block it. Manager thinking for the away side.
That wasn't the way I wanted it to go. Possession. Davis is battling.
Given away once more. Can they hold on here? The fans are doing their best to give them the support. The opposition are doing their best to ruin the day.
They are. I mean, the natural instinct is to drop back and try and defend what you've got. It might be a costly method, that.
And it's Ricky Lambert.
Go on, move, Snydlin, let's go.
Adam Lallana. Morgan Schneiderlin. Building steadily here, keeping possession.
Oh! Oh, it's Valdo.
A corner. And it's put the
opponent took the touch, knocked it forward for him. He picked it up and I just thought, I'm going to hit this. It fell back to me, I may as well. It's a hell of a shot, powerful. Can we make something from this corner? The last thing we want them to do here is, though, we don't want them to clear it and make a break on us. Good ball in. Good ball in. Oh, it's Osvaldo again in the 88th minute. We have gotten 2-0 up. Golazo! Brilliant. Lovely ball in. Front post. Bang. Osvaldo. Easy. No problem. Do we need a striker? This is the question. Can Osvaldo be our heading machine? Oh no.
Chance for him.
Oh, lovely block. Lovely. Oh, he's injured as well. What a shame.
Well, that's in the remit now of the referee. Player's not
fair tackle.
It's stopped because the referee says this player needs some treatment. Well, they're going to take him off, Alan. I'm not sure he wants to go off, but maybe they're just thinking ahead.
And that should be it now. Once the keeper kicks, this should be all over.
He's a valuable player.
I'm hoping.
To this team, and they don't want him out for any longer than necessary.
Not easy to get the ball like.
There we go. It's all over. 2-0. That's the end of the pre-season games.
Swashbuckling at times, wasn't it? The way they poured forward, and the opposition just couldn't handle them.
So it's full time with a final score 2-0. I leave you with the full match highlights, and until next time, I've been Jeff Stelling.
Right, guys, and just before we end it, we're just going to nip to the old office, and I've seen some good news there. St. Etienne have accepted our offer for Kurt Zouma. $3.2 million, and Billy Sharp, and he wants $8,000 a week, which we can afford, and he wants a 4-year contract. And he can be exactly what he is at St. Etienne. He can be an important first-team player because he's going to be mainly playing most of the games, but we're also going to have to give Lovren and Fonte a chance as well. So we'll kind of just rotate between them every couple of games. So we will submit that, and hopefully in the next episode we will have signed Kurt Zouma. We can hope. We also have a player conversation just off Jay Rodriguez saying basically thanks for letting him play, which is no problem. Player injury. See, Gaston Ramirez, bruised elbow, and he's out for 8 days. Seems a lot for a bruised elbow. And Juventus again have rejected the offer. But never mind, what we'll do is we will look at making another offer next episode. So I'd like to thank you all for tuning in. If you enjoyed this video, hit the thumbs up, comment down below, and even tweet me if you like. Thanks for all watching. It's been your boy, Brothers. Peace out.